First movement we're going to go over is the snatch. Now we can do three variations of the snatch. We can do the muscle snatch, the power snatch, and the squat snatch. And now at the top, we have to show control from the wrist all the way down to the ankle and be completely locked out. And it has to bring his feet underneath the shoulders. And that would be a good rep. The next movement is the clean and jerk. You can do any variation of the clean, from muscle clean to the power clean to the squat clean and the split clean if you choose. Now, at the top position of the clean, you have the bar in the rack position, completely locked out from the shoulder to the ankle and feet underneath the shoulders. From this position, you can choose any way to get the bar from your shoulder overhead, from press, push press, push jerk, and split jerk. At the top of the jerk, your feet must be brought back underneath the shoulders, completely locked out from the wrist, shoulder, hip, all the way down to the ankle, and head through the shoulders. This would be a good rep. The next movement we're going to go over is the hang snatch. The hang snatch will start in the hang position. If the snatch begins off the ground, it will be a no rep. It has to start in the hang position, locked out from the shoulder all the way down, and have to come to a complete stop. Once he's in this position, he can now start his hang snatch. He has to do one fluid movement to the top, one distinct movement to the top, and show control with complete lockout and feet together. If his feet land outside of his shoulders, he has to bring those back in and show control. The next movement is the sumo deadlift high pull. With the sumo deadlift high pull, your hands will start inside the legs. Once you're in this position, you're going to bring the bar up, and it must come in contact or go above the collarbone with full extension at the top. That is a good rep. Now, with the sumo deadlift high pull, there can only be one bend in the knees. Any other bend after that, we consider it a no rep. That is a no rep. If the bar does not go to the collarbone or above, that will also be a no rep. That is a no rep. The next movement is shoulder to overhead. The weight will start on the ground. You'll have to bring it up to your shoulder rack. Once you're in this position, you can do any movement from shoulder to overhead, from press, push press, push jerk, and split jerk. Feet back together underneath the hips and show control at the top from wrist, shoulder, hip, and ankle with head through the arms at the top. That is a good rep. The next movement is the plate burpee. He'll begin the movement by bringing his chest, make contact with the ground. At the top, he will have to jump on the plate and open the hips fully from a straight line from shoulder, hip, to ankle. If he does not reach that, that is a no rep. He does not have to redo the burpee. If his judge says no rep, he just has to jump back on, show complete lockout, and then continue on to his next burpees. The next movement is the double under. The rope has to pass under the feet twice for each one jump. The next movement is the pull-up. With the pull-up, you have to start in a locked-out position and then bring your chin above the plane of the bar. You can do any style of pull-up from strict, kipping, and butterfly. And those are all good reps. You can do a strict toast to bar, a kipping toast to bar, but the feet must come in contact with the bar at the same time. If they don't, it'll be a no rep. That is a no rep. The next movement is bar muscle up. With the bar muscle up, you must start with full lockout at the bottom of the bar And you must end with full lockout in control at the top. At the top, everything must be locked out and he has to have control. At no point during the muscle up can your feet cross the horizontal plane of the bar. The next movement is chest to bar pull-ups. With the chest to bar pull-up, you must start in the hang position, fully locked out. And at the top of the chest to bar, the chest, any part of the chest below the collarbone must come in contact with the bar at the top. You can do these either strict, kipping, or butterfly. Those are all good reps. The next movement is the partner shuttle sprint. The first partner will start behind the cone. When he starts the shuttle sprint, he will go around the other cone and back around the starting cone. When it is time to tag your partner, you must tag your partner's hand behind the cone, and then your partner can start his shuttle sprint. If at any time you knock over a cone of